You know what? I would definitely not want a good-looking doctor. Because, I mean, think about it. They see you at your most vulnerable and probably grossest. Like, imagine Dr. McDreamy walking in, gives you the eyes. He goes, tell me, what are you in here for today? And you have to look him in the eye and go, constipation.
Doctor, doctor, give me the news. I got a bad case of loving you.
Hello, fellow book nerds, and welcome back to my channel. Today is part one of my first series, which is my favorite doctor books. Funny thing is, this is not one of my favorite tropes, but I just happen to read a couple doctor books, so I'm like, might as well make a series out of it while it's fresh in my head. So I want to talk about four books today. The first one is probably my favorite doctor romance novel as of right now, and that's Dr. Stanton by T.L. Swan. It is on Kindle Unlimited. As far as triggers, there's really none. No other woman drama or man drama, no cheating. It's technically part of a series. I didn't know that. I went and read just Dr. Stanton, but you'll know in the book, you'll get to meet his brother and his wife, and their story comes before Dr. Stanton. It doesn't have to be read in any particular order, but if you want to be particular, I'm not sure what that book is called, but it comes before Dr. Stanton. So it could technically be called in a series, but it's really a series of standalones. And I would rank this book easily in my 5-star reads. It's so good, and I was so not expecting it to be that good when going into it, because I've read quite a few doctor romances and they tend to be more on the comedic side, but I was surprised of how serious and deep this book actually got. So this book is about Cameron and Ashley. They meet in Vegas, and it's the typical girl gets hit on by a guy she doesn't like. Girl grabs first random guy to say that's her husband, boyfriend, and it happens to be a good looking guy. That's Cameron. So they have a fun night together. They want to see each other again. Cameron loses his cell phone, which has her number saved in it, and they ultimately don't reconnect. And then the story jumps 4 years later when Ashley moves to California with her son, and she's going to be a resident at a local hospital. And the doctor she's assigned to is none other than Cameron Dr. Stanton. Cameron is your typical entitled, rich, grew up with money asshole. And he really shows it through most of the book. Like, he's a different person in the first part of the book. When he meets Ashley in Vegas, he's funny, go-lucky caring, but then everything is kind of different. You see more of who he really is as Dr. Stanton. I get something happens between him and Ashley. It ultimately causes him to lose his shit and be really, really, really mean to her. And I do understand where he's coming from in it, because he wasn't wrong and she was wrong, but he's also not right in his actions and the way he handles it. And he ultimately does a lot of asshole moves. But don't worry, he makes up for it at the end. You know, he pulls himself together. Cameron doesn't lose who he is. Like, Ashley makes him at the end face what his problem is, and that really comes down to his possession and his need to always get his way, and he works on it. And one thing to say that I did not know, and I almost missed it, there is a Dr. Stanton epilogue book, which is more like a novella that's written in kind of the time frame of mostly after how Dr. Stanton ends and a little bit overlap of how it ends. But I definitely recommend you read that after, because the couple fixes their problems very, very late in Dr. Stanton, so you don't get as much happy time. And boy, do I wish every author would do that. You know, like, if you're gonna make us go through all this pain of this couple and we get like a chapter or like the epilogue of them being together, you don't feel satisfied. You know, there's been more pain than happiness. So just write a little novella where you don't have to worry about like bigger problems or other people affecting their relationship. You know, it's just them living their life. You know, for just half a book, that's, I'll do that every single time if an author wants to give that to us. So to end with this book, would I recommend it? 100%. Would I read it again? Yes, 100%. So the second book I want to talk to is Hotshot Doctor by R.S. Gray. Now, this book is also Kindle Unlimited. As far as triggers, nothing. No other woman drama, no other man drama. Well, actually, I take that back. A smidge other man drama, but it's all in good nature and it's funny. It is not part of a series, completely standalone. And this book is the definition of solid book. You know, there's no angst, there's no drama, really. It's just lighthearted, fun, a goofy heroine with a serious jerk hero. So this book is about Bailey and Matt. So Bailey is a surgical assistant, and the doctor she works for is retiring, so she has to be placed with a new doctor, and the only one available is Matt, the doctor slash surgeon, who is the biggest asshole, and he can't hold an assistant for the life of him because everyone ends up quitting and crying. Bailey and Matt are, it's kind of enemies to lovers, not really friends. They butt heads. She's quirky and kind of sporadic with her personality. The only thing I wasn't crazy about was her sporadic, all over the place personality, and it's kind of funny I'm out of all people that are saying that. I mean, hello, pot calling kettle black much. But like one chapter, she's like, you know what? I'm gonna just take a chance on him. I can't, these feelings aren't going away. And then the next chapter, she's back to being scared and distant from him. I'm like, did you not just decide you were gonna take a chance and then you went back to where you began? I was like, that was a little weird. Though I will say, for a book that's more on the lighthearted side, R.S. Gray did a really good job with detail as far as like surgery and the medical world. Like, it's very detailed. So would I recommend this? Yeah, I completely would. It's fun, lighthearted, good quick read. You can't go wrong. Would I read it again? It's hard to say. I just finished it last week. Maybe, probably not, leaning more on the side of no, but do I regret reading it? Absolutely not. The third book I want to talk about is Wrong by Jana Ashton. This book is unfortunately not on Kindle Unlimited. Triggers, there really aren't any. It's fun, lighthearted, no other man, other woman drama, because the hero was way too possessive for that. It is technically part of a series, because you'll see it says book one, but they're all standalone, so you can read the first one. It doesn't end at a cliffhanger. And again, I would put this in the solid category because it is a romantic comedy. So this story is about Sophie and Luke. Sophie is a college student, and she works at a cafe. And every day, this really attractive guy comes in and gets a coffee, and she always serves him, but she doesn't think he really ever notices her. Sure enough, he does, until one day she decides to go to the clinic at her college and get birth control because she wants to have sex with her boyfriend. And who is the doctor? Luke. These things just don't happen in real life, do they? Like, do you actually go to your doctor and in walks your doctor and he's your one-night stand from the night before, or he's the guy you got into a funder bedder with? Like, does this happen to people? So I read this book a while ago and the details are a little fuzzy, but what I do remember is he is very demanding, very possessive, and he gets what he wants, and what he wants is Sophie, and he does not let up on her at all. He goes after her hard. And Sophie is your typical quirky college student, shy, a virgin, bashful. And these two just have a really funny repertoire going back and forth of his dominant person, older personality, and her younger, shy personality. So like I said, it's a quirky, fun book. You get the dominant male doctor and you get the quirky, fun college student. So would I recommend reading this book? This one, yeah, too. 100% would recommend. Would I read it again? Definitely, because I want to remember it again and remember it more vividly. So the final book I want to talk about in part one of this doctor series is Stone Vows by Samantha Christie. This is on Kindle Unlimited. As far as triggers goes, there really aren't any. There is other woman drama, but it's not drama. It's the one thing about the book I did not like, and I'll explain in a second. It is part of a overall series. It could be read as a standalone, but if you're someone who likes to read the entire of series, be aware there is a big chunk of series prior to it. And rankings, I would put this in the solid category. I'm not crazy about this one. It just fell a little short from what I was expecting, and that's mostly due to the other woman drama, but it's not drama. So this story is about Kyle and Elizabeth, and Kyle is an ER doctor and Elizabeth is a patient who comes in pregnant to one night while he's on call. And the first part of the book, the first part of the book is all Kyle's point of view. So you have to read a lot about his other relationship with this woman. And it's not a dramatic relationship, it's just she's an ER nurse, he's an ER nurse, and they don't have the hours to have a real relationship, so they just sleep together. But you have to read quite a lot of scenes of him sleeping with this other woman, and it goes pretty late into the book. And I'm just not a fan of that, you know, it just went way too long and way too detailed for my liking. But Elizabeth is very, like, mysterious and secretive with her life, so he was feeling kind of, like, aggravated with that and would turn to this other woman a little too much for my liking. Ultimately, it is a slow burn book. Like, you have to wait till, like, 80-something percent for anything to really happen. And even so, it doesn't feel natural. You know, I just felt their connection was lacking a lot through the book. But, you know, this is just my opinion. There's a bunch of other people who really enjoyed the book. It wasn't totally my cup of tea. So would I recommend this book? Probably not, because I know the other woman thing is a big deal for a lot of people, and it bothered me enough, and I'm relatively easygoing. And would I read it again? Of course, no. If I don't recommend it, then I'm not going to read it again. So that is it for some doctor romances that I've read. At the end of each one of these series, I just want to mention one book in the category that I'm looking forward to reading, and that right now is The Doctor by E.L. Todd. It came out last week, I believe, and I went to read it, and luckily I didn't, because come to find out, it is only book one of a four-part series. But luckily, they all seem to come out pretty quickly, so I won't have to wait that long till I read it. So that is all I got for you guys today. As always, happy reading, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye.